Traveling from far and wide to come here, a warm welcome to St. Pius X Church. My friends, we're gathered here for a Mass for Peace. I know the first thing most of us think when we think of that, and maybe even the reason why we came tonight is to pray for peace in our world. We seem like we live in such a troubled and divided world, and we certainly pray for that to our Savior, the Prince of Peace, right? We pray that we may be the peacemakers He has called us to be. Sometimes we come here because we need peace in our hearts. That peace can come from sadness, division in our own families, and sometimes at the loss of a loved one, grief. So we pray for the peace in the heart of all of those who are suffering from grief right now. In a special way, I ask you to please pray for Louise Martin, who went home to the Lord this past Memorial Day. I ask you to please pray that his family is blessed with that great gift of peace in their hearts. They will know that the Lord is always with them and that He is with the Lord. Let us begin by acknowledging our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have revealed that peacemakers are to be called your children, grant, we pray, that we may work without ceasing to establish that justice which alone ensures true and lasting peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. Once more there will be poured on us the Spirit from above. Then shall the wilderness be fertile land, and fertile land become forest. In the wilderness justice will come to live, and integrity in the fertile land. Integrity will bring peace. Justice give lasting security. My people will live in a peaceful home, in safe houses, in quiet dwellings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd.
spread a table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
A reading from the letter of St. James. If there are any wise or learned men among you, let them show it by their good lives, with humility and wisdom in their actions. But if at heart you have the bitterness of jealousy or a self-seeking ambition, never make any claims for yourself or cover up the truth with lies. Principles of this kind are not the wisdom that comes down from above. They are only earthly, animal, and devilish. Wherever you find jealousy and ambition, you find disharmony and wicked things of every kind being done. Whereas the wisdom that comes down from above is essentially something pure. It also makes for peace and is kindly and considerate. It is full of compassion and shows itself by doing good. Nor is there any trace of partiality or hypocrisy in it. Peacemakers, when they work for peace, sow the seeds which will bear fruit in holiness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
This is my gift to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me say, I am going away and shall return. If you loved me, you would have been glad to know that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. I have told you this now before it happens, so when it does happen, you may believe. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, good evening.
Good evening.
And a welcome too, as well to Lewis's family, who's here tonight. Lewis's family, his picture is right off to my right, right there. My friends, I'm going to ask you a question that may be considered provocative right now. We're having a masterpiece tonight. I want you to ask yourself in your heart, will what we do here tonight, here at St. Pius, make any difference? I want you to think about that. I have spoken to a lot of you over these last few years about the state of the world. And there is a common theme running through every single conversation, virtually every conversation I've had in which you're talking to me about the state of the world. And if I had to tell you what that was, it would be this. That the world just seems to be getting more violent, more out of control, from the Russians invading Ukraine, gang violence against the innocent on the streets of Haiti, the horrendous situation in Gaza and Israel, and you're worried about it. Saddened by it, worried about it, and scared. It's why you're here tonight. But, and again, this comes up over and over again, you're also feeling like there seems to be very little any of us can actually do about it. You hear about this on the news all the time, and you feel powerless. This comes up in virtually every conversation I have about this. Is anything you or I, we say or do, going to make any difference? And another way to put that is, you're not just feeling powerless, you tell me you're feeling hopeless. Why ask that question at the beginning of Mass, at the beginning of the homily, pardon me? Now, on one level, this is an understandable reaction. Wars seem to be about power, right? About exerting control over somebody else through threats, aggressive speech, actual physical violence, right? And if you don't have power, just like you and me, well, you start to feel powerless. And this can very easily lead to despair. And despair is just another word for hopelessness. So, my next question is, if you relate to what I just said, that's true, why are you here? If you really felt powerless and hopeless, well, you can do that from a couch at home. You don't need to come here if you're powerless and hopeless. No, I think we're here because even if we feel like that sometimes, deep down, we know, we feel that there is always a reason for hope, always. We are people of the resurrection, my friends, right? And in the end, if it's all about who has the power in the world, well, there is something more powerful than physical force and aggression. It's the power to move a human heart, my friends. Jesus Christ never had a weapon or any army. He never threatened physical violence. He never even exerted power or control over anyone. Everything he said and did was an invitation, not a threat. Jesus' power was to move a human heart, right? Ours, the whole world, to make us think about everything differently. Not fight over who gets the seat of honor. Cardinal Schwan is fond of saying this. He says, not to fight over who gets the seat of honor at the table, but to fight over who gets the towel to wash the feet and everything, right? Jesus' power was the power to move the human heart, to make us think about everything differently. To show us that love is the only thing that will truly last. Because God is love, and so love is the most powerful force of all, more than anything. My friends, the church, our faith, has outlasted empires, dictatorships, wars, violence, oppression, because in the end, it's stronger than all of them. Human hearts united in the belief that through the love of Christ, through faith in Him, even a mountain, the impossible suddenly becomes possible. I think that's why you're here, because you believe that. Even if you feel what I was talking about at the beginning, I feel powerless and hopeless deep down,
you don't really. I just want to share a story with you. This is about a person just like you and me. 1943, a young German Christian named Sophie Scholl, her name was Sophie Scholl, was executed by the Nazis for high treason. Now you would think, with such a grandiose charge like that made against her, that she was a person of some power and influence. In fact, she was just the opposite. She was a 22-year-old college student. She was studying biology and philosophy at the University of Munich, a school she attended with her older brother Hans. She was a pretty normal young woman. She liked marmalade, she liked boys, she liked jazz records, and like most people her age, she liked to dance. One day, Sophie read an anti-Nazi sermon by a Roman Catholic bishop of Munster. Cardinal Clemens von Galen, his name was. It sparked something in her brother, and as well as a close friend, his name is Christoph, to start something they called the White Rose, which was a nonviolent group that secretly distributed leaflets opposing Hitler. The Nazi war machine was one of the most powerful things in human history. And these three students started something to fight against it. Just three young college students. It wasn't a political organization. They didn't, of course, agree with Nazi politics. They found them repugnant. But what to them was not politics. It was to move human hearts. Their faith in Christ is what compelled them to do this. On February 18th, 1943, Sophie and the others brought a suitcase full of leaflets to their school. They left stacks of copies everywhere. They had to be very careful, because if they were caught, something terrible would happen to them. And they were leaving, and Sophie realized they had some extra copies in the suitcase in which they smuggled these into the school. So she went back to the school to leave some of them on the top floor. She had a few left in her hands, and she spontaneously threw them over the balcony, so that they would filter down and people would see them. Somebody saw her do it, a custodian, who either because he was a Nazi sympathizer or was terrified that he might get in trouble, reported her. And a few hours later, she and her brother and her friend were taken into Gestapo custody. Within 2 days, they were on trial for their lives before a Nazi judge. And the next day, less than 4 days after they were caught, she and her brother and Christoph were led to their execution. I'm going to quote what she said while she was in custody. Again, she's going against the most powerful war machine in human history. And this is her attitude. What I did, she says, witnessing to Christ, witnessing to the fact that love is more important than hate, good is more important than evil, despite what the world tells us, is felt by many other people. I would say the people right here. They just haven't expressed it yet. It's like their souls are asleep, but my death will have meaning if all those sleeping souls are awakened. And they were. Sophie's last leaflet was smuggled out of Germany, and 2 months later, Allied forces dropped millions of copies of it all over the German countryside, stirring the faith of countless German souls. She still does. Today in Germany, there are 190 schools named after Sophie Scholl. And in a recent poll, almost 80 years later, when the people of Germany were asked to name the greatest Germans who ever lived, Sophie came in second. My friends, peace, just like the song says, really does begin with us. We are not powerless, and nothing is ever hopeless. I'll repeat that. We are not powerless, and nothing is ever hopeless. Every time, through our example, we move one human heart to Jesus, like Sophie, like countless others, it will awaken a soul, and it will make a difference. So don't lose hope. You have more power than you know, and it's the strongest kind of power, because it comes from Him.
Please stand. United in our love of Christ, our desire to be witnesses to Christ, to be the light to the world, the peacemakers he has called us to be, we bring our prayers to him.
For the church, for unity among its leaders, and peace among the faithful, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prophets of peace in our world, and for their message of harmony among all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all experiencing internal discord in their life, for a renewal of hope and a willingness to grow, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer the effects of conflict, for an easing of the pain of division, and a commitment to healing words and deeds, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For harmony in this community, for dialogue in times of disagreement and respect, and for peace in our world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil leaders, that they turn resources toward peace and away from war, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that we may all have peace in our hearts. We pray especially for those who might be grieving the loss of a loved one, in a special way for the family of Louise Martin, that they may know the peace that only Christ can bring. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all the prayers which we hold in the quiet of our hearts. For these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Almighty God, you are our strength. May we always be witnesses to the strength of your love. Always trust that love is stronger than hate, that good is stronger than evil, that light is stronger than the darkness. We ask you to hear and answer our prayers and to grant them according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join in our offertory hymn number 647, Fly Like a Bird.
May the saving sacrifice of your Son, the King of Peace, offered under sacramental signs that signify peace and unity, strengthen, we pray, O Lord, concord among all your children, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gather women and men whom you have made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory. As a joyful celebration, we acclaim. Sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
By our partaking of this mystery, O Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known, and bid them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and martyrs, with St. Pius X, St. Anne, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you. Let us pray. O God of peace, who art peace itself, and who a spirit of discord cannot grasp, nor a violent mind esteem, grant that those who are one in heart may persevere in what is good, and that those in conflict may forget evil, and so be healed. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, as you came in, we saw the prayer of St. Francis. You probably have a copy with you. I think it's a powerful reminder to us that Christ is our strength, my friends, and that through him is how peace through our belief in him, peace will reign certainly on this earth by our witnessing to the peace that only he can bring. Please join me in praying the prayer of St. Francis.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, repair it. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
My friends, I would also encourage you at some point this week, if you get a chance, you can read the leaflets that Sophie and her brother and their friend put together, including the leaflet that was dropped all over Germany and moved all those human hearts. Her name is Sophie Scholl, S-C-H-O-L-L. You can access these letters online. They're quite powerful, my friends, and they're really a power and a testament of never losing hope and the strength that comes through faith in Christ, the strength that ultimately will always bring peace. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
And just a small announcement. Millie would like to invite everyone downstairs for some light refreshments. And please join in our closing hymn, number 672, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Thank you.